Night last night. Welcome any visitors or guests this morning. Any visitors or guests to acknowledge today? No? Okay. We're starting another session of Grief Share Ministry Program here at HUM. Sessions will begin on Saturday, January 14th and end on April 8th. If you or someone you know is mourning the loss of a loved one, please consider inviting them to Grief Share. There's information posted in the bulletin. You can also contact Jessica Rulo for more information. The Faith Seekers Sunday School class will be showing the movie War Room following the church service next Sunday, January 8th. This movie shows how a family incorporates powerful prayer into their life and the struggles they can face through the power of prayer. All are invited to attend, and there will be a small luncheon provided by the class. Again, that's next Sunday, January 8th. Please join our relay team at Quaker Steak and Lube on Elm Road Monday, January 9th from 4 to 10 p.m. Quaker Steak will donate 5% of their sales to the relay team, and I think this also applies to carryout orders. So please come out and support our relay team on January 9th. Trustees will meet tomorrow night, January 2nd at 7 p.m. here at the church. And the acolyte schedule for the remainder of the school year is now posted on the bulletin board, so please check that out if you have kids that are acolytes during this school year. Any other announcements this morning? Okay. Flowers on the altar are given by Dick and Barb McLean in celebration of Jeff and Carrie McLean's 25th wedding anniversary. Are they here this morning? Catch them next week. Say congratulations. Any other announcements this morning? Okay, let's take time to greet one another.
Faces, please, we're going to join firmly grounded in singing Here I Am to Worship.
Here I am to worship, here I am to bow. Will you please join with me in prayer? Lord, you make all things new. You bring hope alive in our hearts and cause our spirits to be born again. Thank you for this new year, for all the potential it holds. Come and kindle in us a mighty flame so that in our time, many will see the wonders of God and live forever to praise your glorious name. Amen. You may be seated. At this time, I'd like the children to come up for the children's sermon. Good morning. It's a light crowd, but that's okay. So this, do you know who this is? This is my big brother, Sean. He's kind of big and scary. It's okay. He is going to help me this morning. So I brought with me a few things. Do you guys know what this is? What is it? It's a whale. It's a killer whale, an orca. Here, hold that. Thanks, Sean. And this is a little teddy bear. His name's Roscoe. Here, hold that. Is it? Oh my gosh, twinsies. Oh no, try again. Oh yes. And we have a little Tigger. You guys know Winnie the Pooh? I have a little Tigger. All right, Sean, what do you think about these stuffed animals? A bit worn. I don't have a microphone for you, so you might need to speak up a little bit more.
Well, they're very worn, frankly.
I know, like this, look, he doesn't have a nose. He's pretty gross. Oh, I know. This one, look, where's his nose? It's like hanging off. And this guy, he looks the nicest of the bunch, but I promise you he's not. These fins have been reattached so many times, he is not new anymore. Hey, Mom, how many times have these fins been reattached? Dozens is what she says. He's gone through plenty of swims. He used to be white. Is that white? It's like a brown. He's been bleached, though, and he still looks like this. Look at his eyes. Do they look new? No, they look scratched up. So these toys, they look like they've been, I don't know, forgotten about, don't they? Like they're dirty. Maybe they've been run over by a bicycle or something. They're gross. Well, the truth is, I'm having trouble with this microphone because it took three people to get this microphone on me this morning. The truth is that they weren't left alone. They weren't forgotten about. These are my toys from when I was your age. This is Shamu. I got Shamu when I was 2 years old. That was almost 19 years ago. I know. So Shamu, we got Shamu by sending in the freezer section in grocery stores. We can get ice cream and stuff, good stuff. There's a fish brand. Called CPAC. And back in 1998, you could send in labels, and they sent you this in the mail. Yes, they sent this in the mail. And I've had him ever since. He's gone with me everywhere. He even came to college with me. And here's Tigger. Tigger got to go to Disney World. I know, that's me when I was cute, right? That's us together. Back when we were little. Does that look like me? Does it? No, it doesn't. It's okay. It is. I promise you, it's me. Outside of Animal Kingdom. And my mom even made a leash for him. He had a leash, and it wrapped around my arm. So they weren't forgotten about. In fact, they've gone on all sorts of journeys with me. They've been to Canada, and they go to college with me. So, but you guys didn't know that to look at them, right? You didn't know that, right? So it's important to remember that everything has a story behind it. So you don't always know what something has gone through. They're different on the inside. Does that make sense? So they looked neglected, but they weren't. They looked this way because they were loved. All right, will you join with me in prayer? Heavenly Father, I just ask that you watch over each child here this morning and over this congregation. Hope that you look out for them with this coming weather, that hopefully it stays nice. Bless this new year and hope for good things for all. And I ask you to look out for each of these children as they go back to school in the next few weeks. In your name we pray, amen. All right.
We offer our prayers to God with our joys and concerns. If you have a joy or a concern you wish to share this morning, please raise your hand and an usher will bring you a microphone. Please continue to keep the Monroe family in your prayers upon the recent passing of Ed's father.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy New Year. It's not a joy or concern, a prayer request, something to put on your heart. I lost a really good friend on Christmas Day. I was going to pull it together. He was my boss when I was in Indiana. He was a mentor from that time until now. And it was really sudden. He was 46. Keep him. If you're the kind of person that prays for a safe passage, do that. He has a family, two college-age kids. One's a freshman, one's a senior. And really two communities, one in New Philadelphia and the other one in Greenfield, Indiana, that are really hurt right now. So if you can just do what you do, appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you.
I have two. One is actually a joy. Matthew, our son Matthew, we had on the prayer chain. He was found out he had a hole in one retina, and he had what was called lattice degeneration in the retina in the other eye. So he was to see a specialist this past week, and he actually got good news that everything looks like it's healing well, and they're just going to see him in a year. So that's thank you for praying for him the last couple weeks. Also, I have a prayer request. My Aunt Virginia Corbin has been on the prayer thing for the last year or so. They have put her in hospice care, so she's not expected to make it here too much longer. So please pray for the Corbin family. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bob Buckland. I know most of you. But my wife and I just come through a really rough time the last 4 months. She's finally starting to eat, and she's getting out a little bit. But we've got a long way to go. But I want to thank you for your prayers, for the cards, for the from the men's breakfast especially, and from our old Sunday school class. And this guy in the funny shirt over here, Pastor Tom, I don't think he's a pastor. I think he's an angel in the big body. Thank you, Tom.
Continue prayers for Jan as well. Thank you. Any other joys or concerns to share this morning? Okay, seeing none, we'll sing together prayer hymn number 254, We Three Kings.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, we come before you today in need of your healing hand. In you, all things are made possible. Hold our hearts within yours and renew our minds, bodies, and souls. You gave us life, and you also gave us joy. Give us all the strength to move forward on the path you've laid out for us. We lift up all the names laid out before us today, that you may place your healing hand upon all of them. And we ask for healing as we pray together the prayer that you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, I welcome the ushers to come forward for the offertory.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, the light of the world has come. We ask that your light shine brightly in our lives as we embark on a new year. We place this offering upon your altar as an outpouring of your light within us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. You can remain standing as we sing together the First Noel.
Thank you.
You may be seated. Sorry. The scripture reading for today is Ephesians 5, 15 to 17, and that is, "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is." Will you please join with me in prayer? Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, amen. For those of you who may not know me, I guess I will preface this with a little bit about myself. My name is Erin Norton. I've been going to this church since I was 2 days old. So 20 and a half years. I graduated from Halland High School in 2014, and I am just finished my junior year at the University of Mount Union, so I'm now a senior. I am a senior international affairs and diplomacy major with a minor in German. If you're wondering what that entails, it's a branch of political science that focuses on international relations, politics, culture, and language. So basically, I just hope to work for a nonprofit or an NGO after graduation. But my actual dream, and my parents are kind of encouraging this, I want to be president one day. Oh, yeah. I know. My mom bought me a coffee mug that says "me for president" on it. I wish I brought it, but I left it at school. So my sermon title is "Why I'm Not a Pessimist." Now, I'm sure you're wondering, Erin, how can you be an optimist with everything that's going on in the world? And you're right. We're living in a messed up world, and I spend every day learning about it. I study terrorism, and I look at political theories to explain why wars occur. See, the thing is, it's not all bad, because I use those same political theories that I use to explain wars to explain why peace happens, too. Yes, the world is messy, but it's not all bad. I keep seeing posts on Facebook and Instagram about all the terrible things that happened in 2016. And yes, there were some pretty terrible things that happened in 2016. But there are some pretty great things that happened in 2016, too. But as humans, we tend to focus on the bad. So I compiled a list of all the good things that happened in 2016. Are you ready? New chemotherapy breakthroughs have increased the 5-year survival rate of pancreatic cancer from 16% to 27%. That is an 11% increase, and it's getting better. That's incredible. Child mortality is down everywhere in the world, and it keeps going down. Do you remember the ice bucket challenge in 2015 where everyone was dumping buckets of ice on their heads? Well, the funds raised from the ice bucket challenge, scientists were able to find the gene responsible for ALS, which means that we're so much closer to an effective treatment. That's remarkable. Oh my gosh, it's so exciting. The numbers of tigers, manatees, and pandas is all increasing over the world. Volunteers in India planted 50 million trees in 24 hours. Wow. 500 elephants were relocated to better homes. And I love elephants, that's why I had to throw that one in there, too. Death by heart disease has decreased by 70% in the United States. 70% in 2016. And Portugal ran its entire nation solely on renewable energy for 4 days straight. What? There were birthdays, Thanksgiving, I love Thanksgiving, Christmas, love Christmas. Families grew, people survived illnesses, the list goes on and on. 2016 was not a bad year. I became an optimistic person when I realized that focusing strictly on the bad things I was learning about in my classes was consuming me. It was breaking me down. Today marks the first of the new year, 2017, whoop whoop, which also means New Year's resolutions. The top 5 New Year's resolutions for this year happen to be stay fit and healthy, lose weight, enjoy life to its fullest, that's mine, it's mine every year, spend less, save more, and spend more time with friends and family.
Now, these are all wonderful resolutions, don't get me wrong. But I have one resolution for you all to consider. Be more optimistic. We can't predict what's going to happen in 2017. I mean, I guess we can guess what might happen, but we don't know for sure. And there's going to be bad things that happen in 2017. Because there's bad things that happen every year. But don't let it consume you. Hear what God has to say, and you will get through. So there are verses in the Bible that can actually help us tackle 2017. So I chose one of them today. So the scripture for today being Ephesians 5:15-17, but we're going to take it verse by verse. So the first verse, verse 15, says, "Be careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise." We are all guilty of living too fast. We make hasty decisions. We speak without thinking. We move fast. We react fast. We answer questions before we even hear the question. We hurry through life. Kind of like the white rabbit from Alice in Wonderland, because he's constantly late, so he's hurrying around. But what can happen when you hurry? Well, you don't watch where you're going, and you trip and fall. When you slow down enough to get God involved, we can discover that he does so much more through us than we could ever accomplish on our own. So do you remember that acronym we all learned in Sunday school? WWJD, what would Jesus do? Okay, so when you're rushing, take a moment to stop and think, WWJD, what would Jesus do? I am known for rushing. I'm constantly rushing around. In fact, there are days when my housemates don't see me because I'm gone before they wake up, and I don't get back until they're already asleep. My usual schedule is I wake up at 6 a.m., which is really early for a college student, let me tell you that. Nobody is on campus that early. And I work at 7 a.m. I go straight from work to class. So on Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, I finish class at like 10 a.m., but then I have homework to do. And with my major, I have a lot of homework. I usually have between 100 and 150 pages of reading a day. Yeah. And it's on, like, democratic peace theory. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have classes till 4. And then in addition to that, I'm also president of my sorority and German club. I'm vice president of MAL United Nations, and I'm treasurer for all 10 spiritual life organizations on campus. So I'm at meetings all the time. I know, some they're smiling over here because they think it's hysterical. When I decided to do all these things, I talked to my mom. I talked to my mom every day. And she was like, "Erin, can you do this? Are you sure you're going to be able to do this?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'll be fine. I was not fine. I got stressed, and I broke down a couple times. So I decided to change. So last semester, I decided I'm rushing Monday through Friday. Saturdays and Sundays, they're going to be for me. They're my days. I'm going to do what I want. Stay in pajamas sometimes. Go to the gym. I get caught up on my favorite television shows. There's a lot of them. I watch a lot of television. But mostly, I spend the time slowing down. You have to slow down in order for God to work through you. And remember, WWJD, what would Jesus do? Verse 16 says, "Making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil." Paul wrote these words while chained to the guards in a Roman jail. The emperor at the time was Nero, who was a horrible man. He literally set fire to Rome and then blamed the Christians. He then ordered Paul to be beheaded. And then the clouds of persecution were rolling in on the horizon. And as the gospel was spread, people began seeing Christians as threats. See, there have always been bad times. There was bad times when this verse was written. The problem is sometimes we give up too soon. But hard times are actually, they're kind of like blessings in disguise. They bring people together. They make people stronger. If those early Christians had given up, then we wouldn't be in this room today. Not only do hard times bring people together, but they also bring people closer to God. I know Pastor Matt has mentioned in the past, but I'm just going to restate it. After 9/11 happened, churches were packed with people. When I was younger, I went through a traumatic experience, which I didn't think I was going to make it through. I suffered from severe depression, and to this day, I still suffer from PTSD. But do you know what got me through it? All of you. My Christian family, I don't say my church family because I have a Christian family at school too. You were all here for me, and most of you didn't even know what you meant to me. See, I would walk through these doors, and I'd have people ask me how I'm doing and generally care what I thought, which it just means so much. Not only do I have all of you, but I actually grew close to the chaplain on Mount Union's campus, especially after, in 2015, one of my sorority sisters and a really good friend of mine decided that her life was not worth it anymore. So I decided that I wouldn't let that happen again. So I grew close to the chaplain, and she's become a second mom for me. She has taught me what she knows, which has also helped me become more optimistic. And remember how I mentioned that I was in a sorority? Well, it's not a Greek life sorority. In fact, it's a fellowship of Christian women who have all become my best friends. I look towards the good even with all the bad happening. Finally, verse 17 says, "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Understand that God has a plan for each and every one of us, and we have no control over it. So don't dwell on things. Look to the good, because even with all the bad, there's plenty of good in the world. I mean, look at all that list. That's pretty great. Remember the New Year's resolution I mentioned towards the beginning? Be more optimistic. I didn't say be an optimist, because it's impossible to be an optimist all the time. We all have our breaking points. I can be a little pessimistic sometimes, but I try to be optimistic. So you just have to remember to slow down, take in the world around you, and remember that Jesus conquered the grave, and because he lives, we all get to live, which is pretty great. Amen. At this time, if we could all stand and join in the closing hymn, 364, Because He Lives. As we start this new year, I'm sure some of you have resolutions. Some of you might not have written some. But I ask you all to consider one resolution. Be more optimistic, because there are better things to come. With that being said, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. Amen.